The State Party launched a major policy reform to the welfare system. Views of persons with disabilities were not meaningfully taken into account in the decision-making and had little or no influence on policy decisions. Measures have caused financial hardship to persons with disabilities, resulting in arrears, debts, evictions, and cuts to essentials such as housing and food. Claimants saw support that they received substantially reduced, so their essential needs such as daily personal care were not sufficiently covered. The reforms have resulted in people experiencing increased reliance on family and kinship carers, reduction in their social interaction, increased isolation, and, in certain cases, institutionalisation. Reduction in services at the local level has curtailed the ability of disabled people to take part in community life. Persons with disabilities have been regularly portrayed negatively as being dependent or making a living out of benefits, committing fraud as benefit claimants, being lazy, and putting a burden on taxpayers who are paying money for nothing. Persons with disabilities continue to experience increasing hostility, aggressive behaviour, and sometimes attacks to their personal integrity. The inquiry also found no substantiation of the alleged benefit fraud by persons with disabilities. The State Party have met the threshold of grave or systematic violations of the rights of persons with disabilities.
Thank you. Founded in 1969 by the Church of Scientology, the Citizens Commission on Human Rights investigates and exposes psychiatric violations of human rights. From its international headquarters in Los Angeles, California, CCHR documents psychiatry's invasive and destructive practices and publishes its findings, making them available in some 15 languages. More than 12 million copies have been distributed to healthcare professionals, government officials, educators, and business leaders world over. The headquarters is also the site of the world-renowned exhibit, Psychiatry, an Industry of Death. Centered around 14 documentary films, this state-of-the-art exhibition presents the history of psychiatry, from its origins, where the mentally ill were caged like animals, to the present-day mass drugging of society as the cure for invented mental disorders. Traveling versions of the exhibit visit hundreds of cities across five continents, opening the way for hundreds of thousands to discover for themselves the dark truth behind psychiatry. What is today a global human rights movement began more than 30 years ago with a fight for the freedom of one individual, Victor Chiori, forcibly committed to a Pennsylvania psychiatric hospital.
He was interviewed by a psychiatrist who said, "I can't understand a word this man is saying. He's incoherent. Obviously, a paranoid schizophrenic. Commit him," which they did. Now, he wasn't babbling incoherently. He was speaking Hungarian. We filed a lawsuit against the hospital. In the middle of the case, the doctor, who was the head of the hospital, stands up and he says, "We want nothing more to do with Victor Chiori."
The release of Victor Chiori was the first of thousands of cases throughout the world helped by CCHR.
CCHR challenged involuntary commitment laws throughout the United States and internationally, and what we found was that people were being incarcerated without any legal rights.
They had no right to an attorney. They could be drugged, shot, lobotomized without their consent.
Example, Australia, 1977, where CCHR exposed a psychiatric practice called deep sleep treatment.
Patients were being knocked unconscious with a cocktail of barbiturates and other psychiatric drugs, and they were being subjected to electroshock treatment daily, sometimes twice daily, without their knowledge. Deep sleep treatment had led to 48 deaths.
It was CCHR that investigated it, exposed it, and fought for over a decade until deep sleep treatment was banned. In South Africa, CCHR exposed psychiatric camps where mental patients were kept and brutalized and then farmed out as slave labor. In Italy, CCHR worked with legislators and the media, conducting raids on psychiatric hospitals, the conditions of which were barbaric, and CCHR got them shut down. In Japan, CCHR exposed the financial crimes of psychiatrists and hospitals that were defrauding the government and taxpayers. The guilty were tried and the hospitals put out of business. And in the United States, CCHR uncovered a $1 billion fraud in the nation's largest chain of private mental health facilities. 600 federal agents conducted raids across 20 states. Dozens of prosecutions ensued, millions of dollars in fines imposed, and the entire chain of corrupt hospitals was permanently closed. And behind many public warnings you see today about psychiatric drugs is CCHR.
CCHR has documented the side effects of these drugs, has taken evidence to the FDA, has gone to Congress, has obtained congressional hearings.
It took 13 years before the FDA finally admitted that those drugs can cause suicide and issued black box warnings. We got 9 state laws passed. Following that, it was the introduction of the Child Medication Safety Act in 2004.
Over a 3-year period, due to the efforts of CCHR and others, there have been more than 60 government warnings exposing the dangers of psychiatric drugs.
People do have problems in life. Sometimes they can be very serious. But the last thing you want to do is hurt them, and that's what psychiatric treatment does. There are alternatives. There are treatments and methods that will actually help people without the violence of drugs and electroshock. And they're economical as well. And that is a threat to a vested interest that is making billions of dollars from psychiatric drugs every year.
History has shown that virtually every workable treatment, every one that has been available for the seriously mentally disturbed, people who actually need help, has been suppressed or shut down by the vested interests of psychiatry and the pharmaceutical industry.
The public's largely been getting their information from the industry that benefits on putting them on psychiatric drugs. It's an advertising campaign. It's not science, it's marketing.
CCHR is causing things to change by being champions for a growing number of well-intentioned people who are risking their professional careers to speak up against the abuses of psychiatry.
Having that support from a group like this has made a tremendous difference in what I feel personally that I've been able to accomplish.
I think of CCHR as fellow soldiers.
I'm unaware of any other organization that does the kind of work that CCHR does, particularly on the scope and the level that they do.
CCHR has been very effective at moving the ball down the field, one at a time, one state at a time, one legislator at a time.
CCHR has had the resources to be able to teach and have legislators become more aware of what the problem with the psychotropic drugs are.
CCHR has researched the issue. When you need the facts, you go to CCHR.
Today, CCHR has over 250 chapters in dozens of countries around the world. Wherever and whenever psychiatrists abuse human rights, CCHR takes its message to the streets. From the United States to Japan, and from Canada to the United Kingdom, prominent members of CCHR lead marches to secure the protection and freedom from psychiatric abuse for everyone.
It's essential that CCHR does their job and gets the support to do their job, because the extent to which they do, the whole vehicle that's out of control about psychiatry gets to be contained and gets to be eliminated. It scares me to think if this doesn't happen. I've seen up close what it's like. Scares the daylights out of me.
You have 100,000 people electroshocked every year. You have 17 million children worldwide taking mind-altering drugs. You have people being involuntarily committed every 75 seconds, and it's all under the guise of mental health.
The only way that you are going to get humane treatment into the mental health system is to take psychiatry and the vested interests out of the picture. And only then will you see people truly obtaining mental health.
You have two choices. Either you pretend you knew nothing about it, or you do something about it. With knowledge comes responsibility. That's why we're here. That's why people are joining forces with CCHR.
Thousands from every faith and walk of life have already joined. CCHR investigates and exposes psychiatric violations of human rights, and will continue to do so until psychiatry's abusive and coercive practices cease, and human rights and dignity are returned to all. Your help is needed. Join us in the fight.